So today we are going to be heading about 10 minutes down the road. Obviously the next bit's going to be time lapse, so it shouldn't be that long, but I'm sure we're going to get there in no time. So as we all know, montage time, baby. So we have reached to our destination. So we're in one of the new, really new parts of my beautiful town, Brackley. So we're going to quickly just pop over here. I'm just going to give you like a small little showing what was going on. So this used to be a beautiful town. Hello everybody and welcome to the channel. Welcome to the cycling kingdom. And today we're having a bit more of a interesting historical video, because today I am travelling to one of Brackley's two old railway lines. So here in Brackley, there used to be two railway lines that both shut around the 1960s. And basically, the one that we're going to travel on, I don't know the name of it, but I've always nicknamed it the County Line. That is because it linked Buckinghamshire, Northamptonshire, Oxfordshire, you name it. And then above this old railway line here, my old favourite railway line, the Great Central, connected to them. Let's go and visit. So let's enter here. So the great part about this railway line, it's very wooded and it's such a beautiful spot. Welcome to an old railway line. So this right here is where there were two tracks. And basically, to say it was in 1960s, right now you'd be seeing trains come past. And the nearest station is just up the high street, near the old part of town. And it's been converted to a cafe called the Great Central Cafe, which I think is absolutely amazing. So right here was there'd be two tracks, and on this line, Oxfordshire, Buckinghamshire, and my county, Northamptonshire, all together. And you can see in the distance, I don't think you can, but if you get a bit closer, you'll be able to see a beautiful bridge where the two lines crossed each other. So just in the distance over there, you can probably see a little bit of a brick line. So that's where we're going to head to. To this lovely bridge. So as you can see on this bridge right here, this is where two railway lines crossed each other. And basically what happened here was this bridge right here called the Great Central came over this line right here. So I believe there was two tracks here, one track over there. The Great Central, so you see all the leaves up there, they would have gone into the high street over there and it would have gone all the way to that station, and it'd come over this line because there are two different lines. So the one that's over the bridge goes all the way to London, and then this one ends up in like Buckingham and stuff. So I'm going to take you guys up there with my bike and hopefully that works. I'm going to try to attempt to put the bike up this really steep hill, and you know, life's about taking risks. So yeah, let's go up this. So I tried it before and I realized I was on a high gear, so I've gone to a lower gear to see if we can do it. So immediately better than the last time, but you know what, it's gonna be a pain to get my bike back down to square route one, and I can't get any higher than this, which is a shame, and I'm kind of stuck, so I'm gonna have to go down carefully. Oh boy, this is tense. Oh boy, Ho-ho-ho! Alright, well, we're back and safe. Whoa. No. I don't think about taking risks, so you're better taking risks than leaving them. Montage music, baby! Let's stop there. So, it's very nice just to kind of, you know, really hard to imagine that there was a railway line here, like this train's going past, like, come here like 90 years ago, and it'd be steam heaven of this town. And, you know, I really want to get up to this bridge thing, but the steps are too steep, so I'm going to go up this, the streetway, which is still a bit boring, because, the steps are too steep in my opinion, but you know what? Is it worth a try or is it not worth a try? These steps here. Do you think it's worth a try, guys? Let me just show you. So I've tried it once before and it's well, it didn't go well. And once you're high enough, you start kind of like going, woof. Hang on, see you guys in a minute. We found ourselves a little pathway which leads to the railway line, but I'm kind of getting a bit lost because I know that the bridge is that way, but I thought it was this way, so it's kind of hard to get out here. You're going to see why. So the quality might be the camera might be a bit shaky because it's hard to move your wheel on unpaved ground. And then we've got the world's thinnest gate to play with. So yeah. I mean, he does not love a little adventure. He'd be lying if he said no. And then we've got to put this through. Come on, you can do it, Aries. Yes, Aries, you did it. My bike's called Aries, you didn't know. Let's continue searching for that bridge. Guess what? We found this. And I think I know where we are. We're adventuring, you should check all the directions, even if you know the direction you're going. Whoa, this is fast. We're going 20 miles an hour. Sheesh. Right, slow down. Okay, believe it or not, we're on this bridge. So right where we're standing, right here, was where I think two sets of tracks of the Great Central was. This is really interesting. Then unfortunately, obviously, humans had to ruin a little bit of this historic piece by building some horrible houses, cutting off loads of this railway. They built, this used to be a cow's field, I remember that. And then over here, they're building houses where they used, this bit used to be like a massive forest before it was a cow field. Like, you used to get over there where the trees are, and then beyond there, there's another railway line, but they blocked it off for some strange reason. So, let's follow this pathway and hopefully live to tell the tale. 3, 2, 1, drop it. I'm traveling a bit faster because I'm getting more used to Aries because she's behaving like a good girl. So, just she's behaved very well on this track. And let's see if we can. We are struggling down on the normal track because, it's really sludgy. This is a bit sludgy, but it's not as sludgy as the bottom bit. And it's a lake down there, which used to be the rail line as well, but it's now man-made. Yeah, but see, look, the lake is a cycling bit. We could go on the lake if we could, like. And, you know, there's no cycling, but I don't think it hurts to go along this path to find the old railway line. I don't think it hurts. It's not like we're going to the lake anyway. We just need to find back our place to the old railway line. And it's just like a cycling. So, we're currently standing on the bridge, just looking over. This is the original brick and some added brick. But we're currently standing where the British Central was. And you might be wondering why that lake shot was. Well, that's for the next part. Just look at this. It's remarkable what could have been such a polluted, beautiful railway coming into a lovely nature. So it just shows what humans can destroy can be always turned back. And the bit for the lake will be in the next part. So, like always, if you enjoyed today's video, make sure you like, subscribe, and hit that post notification bell so you know when the next video comes about.
goodbye from the Great Central Railway and the Unknown Railway. Bye!